Welcome back to this special North Dakota Today, focused on thanking our veterans. Sponsored by Shooting Star Casino, Manoman and Bagley.
The melancholy sound of a bugle call is a fixture at military funerals. But did you know there are so few buglers available these days that the iconic musical piece is sometimes a recording? Local Honor Guard bugler Tom Linnert says when he found that out, he stepped up to serve once again.
I started when I heard that they were using cassette players, which was popular at the time, but using cassette players to play taps, and I thought, that's not right. And I could play the horn. I'd been in a drum corps after I got out of the service in the Legion Drum Corps. So I thought, well, this is something I can do. I don't think trumpet is that popular anymore. Everything's guitars and electronic stuff. It takes a lot of time out of people's schedules, and not everybody in the world took trumpet when they were in high school. My first thoughts is it makes me want to cry. And because it's final, and that's it. I mean, it's as far as your life on earth. When you get taps, you're out, you're done. And you're moving on to the next life. But taps has always been very, very sad, very moving, and it's, I guess I make people cry.
We're joined now by Tom here in studio. Thank you so much for sharing your story that day at the cemetery and today. Hundreds of funerals. You had kind of a count. Can you tell me how many times have you played?
I'm somewhere around 470 right now.
And you've covered a lot of ground as well.
Yep. I've played as far away as Syracuse, New York, and Lewistown, Montana. I've played out at the State Veterans Cemetery. And I play now with the at the Fargo National Cemetery, and I still play with the Moorhead Legion and VFW.
And, you know, a veteran or not, a service or not, hearing taps, it really moves you, and just something happens on the inside. And you were emotional, even after hundreds of times. Why is it still?
I think it's because it is so final. It's the last respect that we pay towards a veteran in appreciation for what they've done. It is very emotional. The words to the song, I can't read them without crying. And it just, to me, it just is that final piece that just says, you know, job done. You're ready for the next life. And it just, I don't know why it moves. I've had some people say that I made them cry because they're musicians and they'd never heard it played that bad before. Otherwise, I it is emotional, and a lot of people will cry when they hear the taps, and that's supposed to be good for you.
It's part of the mourning process.
Yes.
And you kind of brought it up. Can you tell us a little bit more about the history of taps?
Taps was started during the Civil War, and it was meant to sound the end of the day, and for to let everybody know that basically the words are something to the effect that the day is done and God is nigh. And it was meant to be sounded at the end of the day for peace and quiet, and then it was also written for a funeral when I can't remember the general's name, but I believe it was his son who was killed in action, and he had the bugler write taps just for that. And it's been adopted ever since that time.
Now, from visiting with you, you've had some pretty cool experiences as well happen at funerals when you're playing taps. It seems like something kind of happens, and I think you know which funeral I'm talking about. Can you share the story?
Yep. I played taps out at the Bismarck National Cemetery for the Game Fish Commissioner when he died. And while we were getting ready to fire and play, a bald eagle was flying over the river down below the cemetery. When I started playing taps, the bird came and hovered over the flagpole while I played taps. And after I got done playing taps, it just kind of peeled off and flew away. And there was a story about it in the paper, in the Bismarck Tribune about it. The hard part was not watching the eagle, and because everybody's sitting there pointing up at the eagle, and it was very distracting, but very unique, and I thought for the Game Fish Commissioner that was very appropriate. Nice job, bird.
Yeah, something, a greater power was play there.
It's kind of like the animal said, okay, we got to show some respect for this guy, what can we do? And it was very moving, very good.
And I just feel like a lot of times when one of the family members we talked to said, you know, things happen at these services. He said at the end of his father's service, snow flurries just started to slowly. There's all these small signs that are kind of happen, and mm-hmm. The feels are there for sure. Mm-hmm. You have served as well. We've talked about this as well. You played taps for so many people, many that you didn't know. Do you hope to have someone play taps for you when the day comes?
Oh yes, I do. I'm hoping I can get live taps instead of the recording or a cassette player or a CD player. I hope somebody will, and I think they will. I've got somebody in mind. I haven't talked to him yet, but because I plan on being around for a while yet. I think it's very appropriate, and it's something that basically it's one of the very few things that when you go into the military that they say, you know, we will get you this for sure. They'll promise you nothing, but you know, we'll make sure if you get killed, you get a decent burial. And TAPS is a part of that.
Well, thank you for what you do. I think you did an incredible job, the two services that I heard, and then you played a little bit for us as well. Do you have to practice outside? You're so busy.
Well, I've got to try and warm the horn up before we get out there. When it's this cold out, you never know what's going to happen. I've had some pretty miserable taps, and other times it comes out very nice. But if you're watching orchestra, they always practice and warm up before they start, and I don't get that opportunity, so it's ice cold. And sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. Lately, I've been lucky more than unlucky, so it's been pretty good.
Tom, thank you for your service and your continued service as well.
You're welcome.
Stay with us coming up next here on North Dakota Today. We're going to talk to a Navy veteran about the veteran population here in the region and how much they continue to give back.
We'll be back with more of our veteran special, sponsored by Shooting Star Casino, Monoman, and Bagley.